Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. We've had a lot of launches recently and there is yet another launch scheduled for this week. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, the launch of Starlink 4-17 is expected to lift off on Friday, May 6th at 9:47 a.m. UTC or 5:47 a.m. EDT. YouTuber Dave Lee posted a tweet about Starlink that I want to share. He said, "I'm camping at a remote state park this week with no cell reception. None of my hotspots work, Verizon, AT&T, T-Mobile. So set up Starlink and like magic, high-speed internet. Starlink is changing the game." There is another tweet related to Starlink, this one posted by a Ukrainian politician. It says rough data on Starlink's usage around 150,000 active users per day. This is crucial support for Ukraine's infrastructure and restoring the destroyed territories. Ukraine will stay connected no matter what. There is a tweet by NASA's Launch Services Program of a payload that arrived at KSC to be launched on the Falcon Heavy rocket later this year. They said Psyche arrives at the NASA Kennedy Space Center's launch and landing facility. Psyche will journey to a metal-rich asteroid between Mars and Jupiter to investigate iron cores. Launch targeted for August 1st, 2022. Kathy Luders, NASA's Human Spaceflight Administrator, posted a tweet about the return of the crew-free astronauts. She said, "During a planning call Sunday, Mission Control in Houston told space station astronauts that crew-free continues to target undocking from space station no earlier than 5:05 p.m. Eastern Time Wednesday, May 4th. We'll continue to monitor weather and adjust the return as needed for a safe crew recovery after splashdown." Heading over to Boca Chica, here's a view of the orbital launch site. Crews have been continuing to work on the chopstick catching arms. The work on the orbital launch mount has also been continuing. A lot of work has been going on recently with the structural test stand. Here's the suborbital launch site pad A launch mount with thrust simulators installed. The vacuum raptor thrust simulators have now also been installed. Some new ground support equipment hoses were seen delivered to Boca Chica. Crane parts were seen being moved over to the propellant production site. Work on the new booster transport mount has been continuing. The Star Factory production building is continuing to progress. There's a CNBC article posted about documents released related to the environmental assessment. It says SpaceX must take steps to track and mitigate its impact on endangered species and their habitat in order to gain approvals for testing and commercial launches of its Starship Super Heavy lift launch vehicle in Boca Chica, Texas, according to documents from the US Fish and Wildlife Service obtained by CNBC. Here's a view of the bulkheads currently sitting out in the yard. Booster 7 continues to be worked on in the high bay. Today's video was quite a short one. Nonetheless, like usual, I have to say thank you to Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Girl, for being out there filming the Starbase content. As well, thank you to Nick Ansuini, who was out there filming some of the Starbase content in this video too. Also, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.